lives and believes in me will never die. We brought nothing into this world, but we take nothing out. The steadfast love of the Lord never ceases, his mercies never come to end. They are new every morning, and great is his faithfulness. Blessed are those who mourn, for they will be comforted. We've gathered here this morning to remember before God our brother Martin, to give thanks for his life, to commend him to God, our merciful Redeemer and Judge, to commit his body to be cremated, and to comfort one another in our grief. Our opening prayer. Almighty God, you judge us with infinite mercy and justice, and you love everything you have made. In your mercy, turn the darkness of death into the dawn of new life, and the sorrow of parting into the joy of heaven, through our Saviour Jesus Christ. Amen. Please be seated.
Said at funerals that we gather to say our last farewells to a friend and to a loved one.
for us here this morning, today is far from the last time that Martin will be on our hearts and on our minds.
Thank you. I'm Adam, I'm Martin's littlest brother. I'm a jealous size. So I just want to share some memories of our time with Martin. And say that Martin wasn't in my life long enough is a huge understatement. I'd grown up always knowing about Martin, and I remember always wanting to meet him, but growing up in a pre-internet age, I didn't know whether he knew I existed or not. I never really expected that to happen, but I remember finding out that he actually made contact with our dad, and I remember being absolutely thrilled. I remember our first contact, he added me on Facebook, and despite me being very excited, I sent him a rather nonchalant message, just, "So I guess you're my brother," and he replied equally nonchalantly, "Yeah, I guess I am." And he was, instantly, from that moment. I remember our first meeting, all of us together in Dad Carroll's garden, getting to know each other, enjoying drinks, playing games in the sun. It had always been that way. And that garden was the setting of many a party. Martin was always there. And that's one thing that really shone out of Martin, was how proud he was to have us as his family, the big family that he'd always wanted. And literally any opportunity to be part of that family, he was there. Any chance to visit, he was there. Any chance to show up and support us, he was there. Stag do's, weddings, Christmas, birthdays, he was there. And the November parties, all of us outside by the fire pit, drinking many beers, many wines, Martin imparting his knowledge of the stars and constellations onto his nieces and nephews. And the evening inevitably ended up with me and Martin drunkenly chowing down a cold chili con carne in the kitchen and all of us siblings taking drunken photographs. Martin always had his camera, capturing every possible moment that he could so that he could look back on them. And I'm so glad he did, because now we all can. One of my fondest memories of Martin is Martin, Dad and I getting through an entire bottle of Lafroy whiskey within a couple of hours on Christmas. A drink now will always remind me of him. I remember sitting in the Squirrel Pub in Iwickham with our sister drinking London Pride Shandies, but instead of lemonade we had with Coca-Cola, which sounds horrible but it's really nice. We were deciding what we should call this drink, and Martin thought about it for a little while and said quietly, "Cock." So that was us sitting down in cocks. I remember always making each other. I remember being in the Flint Cottage Pub, lots of pubs, in Iwickham. And he was telling us how his granddad on his mum's side used to drink in the pub years ago. He knew so much about his family history, and I loved that. Martin had painstakingly researched both sides of the family very far back, and his detective skills managed to find our dad's sister, a sister that even our dad didn't know he had, which, as legacies go, is pretty epic. And speaking of legacies, I will never forget how happy he was when he spoke to Charlie and talking. I remember him telling me one night that he met someone, a lady that he loved, a lady that was to be the subject of many a late night phone call. And you know how happy he was to be by her side. And I will always remember our last conversation. We had one of the most frank and honest chats we'd ever had, and for that, I will be eternally grateful. I messaged him the night before he went in for what was to be his last surgery, and I told him that I loved him, and I was sending him good thoughts. And he told me that he was frightened, that he was going to fight. I told him I wanted him to know that as well as being my brother, he was my friend. And I wish he'd been around when we were growing up. And that when we were allowed, we were going to get together with the kids and have a few pints. He would like that, and that he couldn't wait to give me a hug. And I wish he could. Now, Martin was a gentle giant, an interesting man with interesting quirks. And some of you may be aware that he had a thing about being immortal. I'm going to leave you with this. Do not stand by my grave and weep, I buried Elizabeth Fry. Do not stand at my grave and weep, I am not there, I do not see. I am a thousand winds that blow, I am the diamond glints on the snow. I am the sunlight and white with rain, I am the gentle autumn rain. When you awaken in the morning's hush, I am the swift uplifting rush. Quiet birds in circle of light, I am the soft stars that shine at night. Do not stand in my grave and cry, I am not there, I did not die. Thank you.
Thank you, Adam. I know how difficult that is, but it was beautiful. Thank you. Martin has an interesting, maybe not quirky brother. Today we think of words we wanted to say and are no longer can, of deeds which must remain undone. I don't know, I can't imagine, maybe even the odd hurt we can no longer heal. But our task this morning is to not so much be, rather to continue the process wherein we allow Martin to depart. In love and charity, with kind thoughts and prayers, we are here to do right by this good man. We're also here to thank God, creator and sustainer of all life, for Martin's time shared with us. The love, the friendship, the care, the beers that he has shared with us. Love, as you know, leads to commitment. As God's love is absolute, so is his commitment to all men, to all women. It is truly for better, for worse, for richer, for poorer, in sickness and in health, in life and in death, God's love will not let us go. That means he is immortal. Our love for Martin means we shall neither forget nor cease to be influenced by his life, his kindnesses, his affection for us, such as Martin's love. And God's love for Martin means, as it did with Jesus, that even though he leaves this world, neither your loved one nor we are released from his love to us. Putting this very simply, what it means is that as death was not the end of the matter for Jesus, nor is it the end of the matter for Martin, the resurrection of Jesus gives us a sure and certain hope of resurrection to a new life for the one that we have loved and lost for a while. Your partner, your brother, your friend. You probably remember that bit where Jesus says, "Trust in God, trust also in me, in my Father's house. There are many places, otherwise I would have told you, and I am going now to prepare a place for you. After I have gone and prepared your place, I shall return to take you to myself, so that you may be with me where I am." There is, of course, one supreme passage in the Bible talks about the nature of love. I'll ask Catherine, please, to come and read it for us. Are you all right up there? Thank you.
I may speak in tongues of men or of angels, but if I have no love, I am a sounding gong or a clanging cymbal. I may have the gift of prophecy and the knowledge of every hidden truth. I may have faith enough to move mountains, but if I have no love, I am nothing. I may give all I possess to the needy. I may give my body to be burnt, but if I have no love, I gain nothing by it. Love is patient and kind. Love envies no one, is never boastful, never conceited, never rude. Love is never selfish, never quick to take offence. Love keeps no scores of wrongs, takes no pleasure in the sins of others, but delights in the truth. There is nothing love cannot face. There is no limit to its faith, its hope, its endurance. Love will never come to an end. Prophecies will cease, tongues of ecstasy will fall silent, knowledge will vanish. For our knowledge and our prophecy alike are partial, and the partial vanishes when wholeness comes. When I was a child, I spoke like a child, thought like a child, reasoned like a child. But when I grew up, I finished with childish things. At present, we see only puzzling reflections in a mirror, but one day we shall see face to face. My knowledge now is partial. It will be whole, like God's knowledge of me. There are three things that last forever: faith, hope, and love. And the greatest of the three is love.
Beautifully read. Thank you, Catherine. We come now to our prayers. Let us pray. God, our Father, we thank you that you have made each of us in your own image and given us gifts and talents with which to serve you. We thank you for Martin, for the years we shared with him, the good we saw in him, and the love we received from him. Now give us strength and courage to leave him in your care, confident in your promise of eternal life through Jesus Christ our Lord. Amen. Almighty Father, God of all mercies and giver of all comfort, deal graciously, we pray, with those who mourn, especially Charlotte, Torbjörn, Carol, Peter, and God, that casting all their care upon you, they may know the consolation of your love. And this we ask through Jesus Christ our Lord.
You are tender towards your children, and your mercy is over all your works. Heal the memories of hurt and failure. Give us the wisdom and grace to use aright the time that is left for us here on earth. Turn to Christ as to infinite love and to follow in the way that leads to everlasting life.
Support us, O Lord, all the day long of this troublous life, until the shadows lengthen and the evening comes. The busy world is hushed, the fever of life is over, and our work is then, Lord, in your mercy, grant us safe lodging, along with Eva, Sammy, and Jerry, a holy rest, and peace at the last, through Christ our Lord. Amen. Let us pray with confidence in the words that Jesus taught all to pray. We use the traditional words. Our Father, who art in heaven, hallowed be thy name. Thy kingdom come, thy will be done, on earth as it is in heaven. Give us this day our daily bread, and forgive us our trespasses, as we forgive those who trespass against us. And lead us not into temptation, but deliver us from evil. For thine is the kingdom, power and glory, forever and ever. Amen. I'll ask Christian now to come forward and play for us a musical tribute from David Bowie's Life on Mars. Thank you. Thank you. into God's care. Almighty God, you, as you bring us face to face with our mortality, we thank you for making each one of us in your own image and giving us gifts in body, mind, and spirit. We thank you now as we honour the memory of Martin, whom you gave to us and have taken away. We entrust him to your mercy and pray that you will show us the path of life and the fullness of joy in your presence through all eternity. Martin, go forth from your journey from this world in the love of God the Father Almighty who created you, in the mercy of Jesus Christ who suffered death for you, in the power of the Holy Spirit who strengthens you, in communion with the blessed saints and aided by angels and archangels and all the companies of the heavenly host. May your portion this day be in peace, and your dwelling the heavenly Jerusalem. Amen. From 4:8 Requiem, be beautiful in Paradise.
straight after we've heard